It's great to see my recruits. Deputy State Fire Administrator. I present to you Fire Protection Specialist William Taylor, who has served this unit well for 21 years. His affairs are in order, and he's prepared for dismissal.
Welcome, everybody, on this wonderful day to support and congratulate Bill Taylor on a wonderful retirement. Bill has represented the Office of Fire Prevention and Control to the utmost extreme professionalism, and his ability to teach and be around the fire service is second to none. Bill started his career in 2003 as a state fire instructor, teaching many firefighters. Eventually, came on board to work with the Fire Life Safety Branch, inspecting homes of people with disabilities, which is a tremendous special place in my heart, having a family with disabilities. FT program and taught more than 340 firefighters in that program. Then moved on to the Fire Training Operation Branch and began with the Firefighter One program, where he's taught close to 600 fire instructors. What that means is those fire instructors have taught thousands and thousands of firefighters throughout the state of New York, protecting the citizens and visitors of the state of New York, which has exponentially created safety communities and safer communities throughout New York for years to come, long after Bill has retired today. And we can't thank him enough for all of that service. I'd like to thank all the distinguished members of the fire service that are here today, friends and family, and the family of OFPC, who has shared so how thoughtful it is and how much Bill has changed the lives of the fire service in his 21 years with OFPC. I would like to thank his girlfriend Jan, his brother Tom, and his sons Bill, Stephen, and Jack for being here in support today. Thank you for being here. I'm sure Bill appreciates that. This is Grand Fire Department for being outside. It is well deserved, Bill. And I am happy to be here. On behalf of State Fire Administrator Jim Cable, Deputy State Fire Administrator Bill Davis, and Branch Chief Guy Sforna, who offered to be here today. They are here in spirit, and they wanted me to wish you the best of a congratulation and a wonderful retirement, which is well deserved. I would like to bring up a couple of dignitaries who have some stuff for you. First, Commissioner Ronaldo from the City of Buffalo Fire Department.
First of all, thank everyone from OPSC for the invitation, for the gracious invitation. We're certainly very happy to be here today to see Bill. Bill's been a great guy, great person. He's been our go-to person from OPSC for the City of Buffalo. Done a lot for the city and for the fire department, for our city and for our citizens. So I want to thank you, Bill, for your service. And we also have something to present to you. It's extremely rare. Highly sought after Buffalo Fire Department challenge coin. It's a bunch of numbers, there's only a set amount of these that were minted, and we'd like to present one to you today. As a city, you look on the one side, and on the other side, it has the Buffalo Fire Department have one as well. So, welcome.
Next, I'd like to bring up Branch Chief Ben Keller from the Fire Life Safety Branch of OFPC.
Okay, John Tino up with me as well. So, as the Chief mentioned, Bill started his career at Fire Life Safety Branch. For those of you that know Salty Bill as the firefighter, him being a fire inspector might be a little bit of a surprise to you, but Bill embraced it, and I got you, did a great job. John was working a little bit for OPW at the time on the other side, and I know, John, you guys shared a few stories about Bill and his adventures in OPW land, but Bill has completed over 300 inspections, the initial inspections of group homes across the area. These are homes that we were inspecting post the Wells disaster. We lost 4 individuals in a group home in upstate New York, and Bill did it with the utmost respect, courtesy, just a gentleman, and always treated everybody with dignity and respect. There was one story, though, that he shared with John about a particular incident of this. With one group home where he found some issues that needed an extra drill at night to make sure things were going okay. Maybe John can fill in some of the details, but I think it was pointing something like the middle of the night raid on a particular house there, almost like something out of a Grisham now. They showed up with this black SUV, squealing the tires, and pulled in and banged on the door and said, "Fire department, let us in. We need to do a drill now." At least that's what was described to me by the person, the director of the area. Well, I don't know if that was really true or not, but that's kind of what I had heard through the myths and legends of Western New York. I don't know, John, was that how it went down? Did you guys keep screaming in?
Well, Bill was quiet and humble. No, that was not Bill. So, as the DSFA mentioned, Bill has done an astronomical job in his dedication to community service, knowing Bill for about 30 years. As a young kid, he's just an incredible person, incredible man. But in this mission at State Fire, it's tremendous service for the instructors and firefighters he's trained and the thousands of people that he's kept safe during his inspections and education. As Chief Keller mentioned, when the OPWDB and OFPC partnership first started off in the partnership, again, following a fatal fire, the 4 individuals perished in a group home. The State Fire folks had black Suburbans that were very deep feet undercover. And being at OPWDD as the fire rep, Bill and I were riding together a lot. And we pulled up at this home at 3 in the morning, and Bill had knocked on the door, and not quietly said, "Fire department!" And she was looking, the young lady working there was looking for identification. Good job. He put it against the window and said, "Here you go! I'm too short, I can't see it," she says. "They call the cops, lady. I don't know what to tell you." So that's about one of about 150 stories that we have, and probably thousands that are out in the crowd here, many of which can't be told. But a great man, a very humble person, and a very dedicated leader. Look forward to seeing you for many, many years. Continue to give service, and the amount of people that you've kept safe has just been tremendous. Congratulations.
But I wanted to present to you on behalf of the Fire Life Safety Branch a report of inspection and notice of violation. This was conducted January 31st, 2012 at a group home in Jefferson Road in Alcottville, New York. And I believe this was the first inspection that you did. So, and you and Ryan Monticelli both turned in your first inspections of our project the same day. So, I figured I'd let them keep a copy of that. You know, you can do what you wish. You want to, it's suitable for framing if you want to burn it in the fireplace or whatever you want to do. Well, congratulations and thank you for all your service.
Is there anybody else that wanted to present anything to Bill? Bill, the mic is yours.
Andy Jones is with us today, folks. We're going to give him a round of applause. Yeah. On a serious note, thank you. I've said it before, this is humbling. Listening to people and the presentation, Colbert, and of course, the folks. Phenomenal. What really makes it special is that my 3 sons will be with us. And my older brother, Tom, who pretty much showed me the way. And I appreciate appreciate everything he did for me. As for the rest of the group, I can't say thank you enough. We've all been great friends and great professionals. As for the instructors that I was involved with, whether it was the recruit program or the outreach, I'll say it again, the finest instructors in North America. Last but not least, big shout out and thank you to Jim, who has been a real rock for me. I appreciate everything she's done for me. I can't express how much I love her. I could go down the line and name all the names, and that will take us the better part of the afternoon. I'll just say this. Thank you all. You made my dreams come true. Thank you.
I can't tell them that story about that time you were there.
God bless Bill's days of retirement. Letters of life rushed upon him. This we are grateful to God. Amen.
Colleagues.
Thank you, everyone. I appreciate all the help and the support you gave me over the years. I look forward to seeing you in the future. Where I live, you find me. Unless they can call if you're in town, you need to. Otherwise, good luck. Carry on with the mission.